the Brennan family from Commander's Palace. To me, great family, great friends. There's a great reason to shop here at Houses.
This afternoon in the fairgrounds, we'll be full of people attending the first day of Jazz Fest, the second weekend. Today marks the first Thursday opening of the Jazz Fest. We love these Thursdays since the hurricane. And while the events were sharing stuff by the Gospel Dance performance by the Lee Boys, you may not have heard of them, but these guys are good. Their performance today is just the first of a couple of Jazz Fest things they'll be doing around town this weekend. Here with more on their busy weekend in New Orleans is Alvin Lee of the Lee Boys. And thanks for coming in. You guys are playing twice at the Fest.
Yes, we're playing today at Gospel, 10 at 4:30, and tomorrow at the Blues Stage.
That's pretty good to be doing both.
Yeah, we just feel fortunate and blessed that we play twice here.
And now you guys are out of Miami, and it's all family in your band.
Yes, all families, three brothers and three nephews, my sister's son.
Because I was saying, you guys do gospel and jazz. You don't kind of think of that coming out of Miami.
Not all the time, but the Lee Boys, we kind of all over the map with our music, and you just got to come to the gospel stage to check it out.
Now, is that where your roots are in gospel?
Yeah, this music is gospel-based. It comes straight from out of our church, and back in 2001, we decided to take it out of the four walls and spread it to the world.
And now when you guys switch hands and go over to the jazz stage, I mean, you kind of like mix it with gospel and jazz? Or?
Yeah, we just mix it all. And the music is just kind of all over the place. And, we do our gospel, they have a little jazz, and we do our jazz and have a little gospel.
And now has it become like a full-time job now?
Yes, we're doing it full-time. We maybe averaging like 120 days a year, and trying to spread it all over.
And what's it like being on the road with the family? Living at home with the family is hard enough. Traveling with them and in business.
Well, it's unfortunately, it's good. I mean, we have our little ups and downs, but with family, I mean, we was raised the right way, and we kind of know that we got to get along if we want to continue to do more.
Now, is this your first time at Jazz Fest?
Our first time, and we're very excited.
Okay, first time you get two gigs. I'm trying to think of when that's happened before.
I don't know. I just got to give that off to my manager, Barney.
All right, very good. And now, are you playing any place else now?
Yeah, we're going to be playing tonight also at the Blue Now, and then also tomorrow at Chicken Wawa, and then Sunday at the House of Blues.
And when you guys come back. Is there anything you didn't book you on?
I don't know. But we just kind of covered the whole battle here.
All right, we're going to hear some more of you guys playing in a little while. But remember, the Lee Boys will be this afternoon at the Jazz Fest at the AIG Gospel Tent from 4:30 to 5:30. I'll be out there today, so I'm going to stop by and see you guys.
All right.
Tomorrow the group is back at Jazz Fest with Johnny Sketch and the Dirty Notes. Those guys are great, too. You're going to like those
all
guys.
Right, cool.
At the Southern Comfort Blues Tent at 2:55. And on Saturday, as we mentioned, the Lee Boys will be at the Allison Minor Stage at the Jazz Arts Festival for an interview. So you guys are Jazz Fest like three times?
Yes, three times.
Unbelievable.
I forgot about Saturday morning.
There you go. then you mentioned to me the Blue Nile tonight.
Yes, and tomorrow at Chickawawa.
And then when are you going to the House of Blues?
Sunday night. I think we perform at 9.
Well, if you guys get any sleep this week, list of who's going to be at Jazz Fest this weekend, including today and the rest of the weekend. You can go to our website at wwltv.com and click on links on four. All right, thanks for coming, Neil.
Thank
you. Appreciate that. Coming up
in
the next half hour, we'll talk with New Orleans City Council member Cynthia Hedge Morrell, about some of the recovery issues facing Gentilly and other parts of the city. So stay right there.